February 8th meeting of the Mayor with the County Board of Commissioners. We're glad that you're here. Before we get started, if you have a cell phone or other electronic device, if you would please turn it off before we start the meeting. At this time, we're going to stand for the invocation to be led by Commissioner McCoy and remain standing for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Good morning. Why don't we just all do the Lord's Prayer this morning? We haven't done that here, and it was the Lord's model prayer. If you would, just bow. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Before we adopt the agenda, we do have three things that we need to add. Number six will be the joint IDA appointments. Number seven, student protection agreement, protector agreement. And number eight, issuance of RFPs for grass cutting. If there's nothing else to be added, we have a motion to adopt the agenda. We have a second?
Second.
All in favor? We have the minutes from the January 24th work session and the January 24th regular meeting. We've had the opportunity to look at this and read over it. Are there any corrections or deletions that need to be made?
Seeing none, Madam Chair, I move that we go ahead and accept those minutes.
All right, do we have a second?
Second.
All in favor? All right, come down to our municipal comments. We have Mayor Glover from Greenville.
I'll have him do the same.
Thank you. Mayor Prater from Warm Springs.
Good morning, Chairman. Warm Springs is continuing to move forward. I will, in the next couple of weeks, hopefully be making two large announcements for our city that happened yesterday. The hotel is continuing to be on schedule, if not a little bit ahead of schedule, good weather that they had, and things are going well in the city of Warm Springs.
Way to go, Bob. Just keep us all in suspenders.
Mr. Westbury from Manchester.
Good morning, Commissioner.
Good morning.
Big news in Manchester is, of course, the intent of the City Council to sell its natural gas system. We feel like this is going to be a plus for everyone, citizens, users. We believe it's going to help Manchester move forward because the company we're selling to jets itself deeply into the cities it operates in, works closely with your chambers of commerce and development authorities to attract new businesses there because it's only beneficial for them, of course. And we're hoping to be able to close on this deal by the end of May. We had our first town hall meeting last week. We've got the other one scheduled for this coming Monday. Citizen input on it, but it's basically going to be a lot better. They provide better service than we have the resources to do. They're on their own gas lines, so the rates are going to be lower. They can offer citizen discounts, way of senior citizens, low income, something we're not able to do. And just provide free training to the fire department so they won't have to travel somewhere to get this training. Just a lot of pluses to it, and the city's going to be paid well for our system. But very proud of our employees and all that look back to this, that it is in the condition that is in, to attract a good prize for it.
Thank you. Any other cities?
Yes.
Mr. Carl, you have anything for Woodbury?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Any other cities? All right, we'll move on to our constitutional officers, and I don't think I see anybody from any of those offices. Okay. All right, we'll move on to our department heads, and we'll start over here with Keith. Alphonse. Patty. Ron.
Nothing.
Tyrell.
Nothing.
Y'all should get out of here. Ms. Jane.
No, I don't have anything.
Oh, wow.
All right, have I missed anybody? Carolyn could not be here this morning. She is in a family connection meeting, but she did want to remind those that they have the invitation to go to the Capitol Day, the joint venture with Harris and Meriwether Chambers, that if you plan to attend, to please respond. I think it's by the 14th, and that day is on February the 23rd. So she asked that I make that announcement.
Well, Chair, I think there's a Peaches and the Pines meeting today, isn't there? Somebody.
1 o'clock.
1 o'clock in Warm Springs.
We do not have need for a public hearing, so we'll move on to old business, and that's the courthouse wall project.
Yes, ma'am. Got received an email from GDOT yesterday about this project, and they're still working on ways to, to complete the funding. They're asking now, as a possibility, if we might go and break this out into a couple of different proposals, one including the wall, and the other would be the rest of the improvements and safety improvements. You know, I responded back, whatever we need to do to make it work, we'll have to modify and cancel our proposals if we do and work again. But I'll see what they have to say about that. They may leave the wall and the sidewalk responsibility on us, and then they would take care of the balance of that. So we'll see how that, transpires. But I did receive that back, and I had talked to them last week, and they're just, what they're doing is they're just trying to come up with ways, different, possibility they have to be able to accomplish that. So as soon as they let us know which direction we need to go in, I'll bring it back, and we'll go in that direction. So,
well, I think the question, Madam Chair, if we're going to do the wall and the sidewalk, that's our obligation.
That
would be our obligation. Are you going to continue to lead the rest of that project?
They would do the rest of that project.
Would you still be leading it? Okay, they would just do it.
They would need to do that. Because that would really be up to them. Then what we would do is we just manage the wall project.
Okay.
Which, in all honesty, is a little easier.
Absolutely.
But anyway, we'll do whatever we need to do. But I'll keep you guys posted on it. But I have the correspondence last week and this week.
Okay. All right. Next, we have the appointment to the Zoning Board of Appeals. Are we ready for that?
Don't think we're ready
for that. Okay. All right. Can we have a motion to table the Zoning Board of Appeals?
So moved.
Have a second?
Second.
All in favor? Okay. We'll move on to new business. And first, we have an update on recreation. And we have Vic Dallas and Randy Carter both here. So, want to come forward? And
sure. We'll just take a bit of what we walked up to say. What a good job, I believe, that these guys have done with recreation. I think the numbers they're going to show you today is going to reflect, some of the successes. And then, top of that, we're still looking at other ways to expand recreation. So, turn it over to these guys.
Thank you. First of all, I got a lot of help. And it starts right here with them and Carmelis. They do a lot of work out in the county. Getting kids, getting activities involved. Just an update on what we got going on, what we got coming up. We're actually finishing up our basketball leagues. This year we had 27 youth teams, ages 5 to 12. A total of about 190 kids participating. Probably the most we've ever had. We also had 10 adult teams. We had 5 ladies teams, which we've never had. and we had 5 men's teams for the men's league. So it's been a busy 2 or 3 months. Also, we got we're getting ready for picking our all-star teams in basketball. Each age group coaches pick a team, and then they go and play in tournaments and represent our county as the all-stars. Those tournaments will be coming up in a couple weeks. And after that, we're currently in process of signing kids up for T-ball, girls softball, and baseball. And that's for kids ages 4 up to 12 years old again. That's probably the biggest program we've had traditionally, and it's very busy. I've got some stuff I'm going to give y'all on that. This is what I have gone the last week to Unity, Georgie, Mountain View, to all the schools, and put these in there in stacks of homerooms where they put them in the teachers' boxes, and hopefully the teachers pass them out and get the word to the kids. And that's probably the hardest part of the whole program, getting the kids signed up, getting the volunteers to coach them, getting the uniforms and equipment. And that's what we're currently starting right now. Looking for a good season. We also met with the Recreation Advisory Board last week, and they elected officers and talked about some concerns they had and some goals to start working for. That's about it. Mr. Carter's got a few things he'd like to say.
Yeah, well, I think we're hosting the 9-10 district tournament February the 24th and 25th in Woodbury, at the gym in Woodbury. We got about 6 county coming in, a lot of county coming in, a big. I got some of a little post what we did in 2015 versus we did in 2016. Let's see, we went a long way from 15 to 16. In 2015, we'll go over the stuff we did in 2015 up on the recreation event. From December to January 14 to 15, we haven't had 8 basketball games. Youth softball and baseball game in May. We're going to have 2 baseball games and 2 softball games and no T-ball. Then we had women kickball in July for 1 month. That's on Sunday. Then on September, they had only 7 football games. Then when we jumped back up with Manchester event, we went on 2016. We had youth basketball from January the 2nd to March the 5th. We had 6 through 8 girls and boys basketball, 9 and 10 girls and boys basketball, and 9 and 12 girls and boys basketball team. Then we had a women's league basketball in May through July. Then baseball went to April the 2nd to May the 10th. But we left out there. We held the tournament down in Manchester with the 7-8 baseball. Then we had T-ball in June. Then we had summer camp. We hope we can get the summer camp back this year. She want to come back. That was a plus for the kids for all over the county. Then we had football league. We had co-ed and youth volleyball and man volleyball league. Then we had a man basketball league. Now, 2017, we are starting off with the basketball team. We start basketball, youth basketball in the 17. We move forward with that. Like Vic said, we got basketball, T-ball and baseball coming up. We're going to try to keep this schedule like he got right here, what we got on this, all the day, what activities going to be going on during our league, because we got women basketball coming back up right along with that too. Also, Vic, we got together, we're going to do something a little different this year. We got 13-14 basketball we're going to try to do it in June this year, because we're leaving out some kids. Them ages right there don't even make the basketball team, so we're going to try to get them something to do during the summer.
What does that summer camp consist of that you're hoping to get back this year?
That summer camp, it went to the kindergarten all the way through the 12th. What they do is they take trip, teach kids reading, math, and all that, put stuff together.
Kind of combined recreation?
Yes, yeah. But
that interest?
Yeah.
Ms. Ball.
I said Ms. Ball, that's what,
yes.
Ms. Ball headed up? Okay.
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Last year was the first time we'd had it.
Yes, that's the first time we had it. We tried to do a little stuff different and everything move forward to make people get involved. But we, like I say, volunteer very hard this day and time. A lot of people don't want to volunteer now. So, you know, that's one thing we're trying to focus on now, to get more young people involved, volunteer. So we got a couple of my Lutherville right now volunteering, and they're doing a good job with it.
Well, that's good. Looks like you have a lot going on.
Yes, we do.
T-ball, that's a different time than it normally is.
No, we're starting at the same time this time.
But I mean,
yeah, we've been doing it in June.
Yeah, and it is too blasted hot.
That's why we changed it. I mean, it is scorching. And so we're going to try this and see
that's
how it works.
Great.
Any questions? Thanks, y'all.
It looks good. Thank you.
Madam Chair.
Yes.
I have one. What are the times of the 24th and 25th in Woodbury? You moved that by date the
20th. Yes, ma'am. I've double checked. I mean, we had seven teams coming. The Mayberry County team.
I mean, just what time was it actually?
6:00 Friday and 10:00 Saturday.
6 p.m. on Friday and 10 a.m. on Saturday.
And we'll go to the better part of the day on Saturday, and we'll have two games on Friday.
Thank you.
Is there anything that the county needs to do in preparation for that tournament?
Oh, we're ready.
You're ready?
Other than our kids practicing and getting up far.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, next is the appointment to the IDA board of District 4. Are we ready for?
Madam Chair, I ask that we table this at this time. The person that I've been in contact with, I have not heard back from.
Okay.
So I'd like to table it.
Okay. All right. You have a motion to table the appointment. All right. Second. That's it.
Second.
All in favor. All right. Thank you. Appointment to the West Central Georgia Broadband Joint Development Authority. Who has that?
I have a question just before we work on it. It appears to me in reading the information here that if you're appointed to that board and nobody is appointed behind you, you continue to serve on this board.
I think that's
is
right.
Is that the way I'm seeing this?
I think it's looks like the last Board of Fair Weather was a 4-year term, but I'm lucky. I think you continue. It says you continue to hold office until your successor is appointed.
That's exactly what I'm reading.
Who is that person?
It's a former commissioner. Served in that capacity. This might be something that one of the board members might want to, consider. I don't know how active this group is now. They were very active at one time.
I'd just like to clarify that I brought that to Beverly's attention because of who the appointment was. I didn't know you wanted to reappoint someone. The board is not real active right now, but I don't want to disband the authority because in the future we may need the broadband authority. We haven't been meeting on a regular basis. We need to meet at least once a year. So that's the purpose of me bringing it to you. I don't know if you wanted that person to continue or if you wanted to appoint someone.
Okay.
You want this just once a year?
Yeah. Commissioner Craig Gill said he would do it. So make a motion, Commissioner Craig Gill, take this.
So moved.
Second. All in favor, raise your hand. Commissioner Craig Gill.
Okay. Good deal.
All right, next we have retirement plan presentation from Mass Mutual. Gentlemen.
Madam Chair, board members, Jim Fallon with Morgan Stanley, investment consultant. What we're proposing doing is changing the record keepers from the company One America and then going back to Mass Mutual. We had made a change from Mass Mutual back to One America back in 2015 based on Mass Mutual's insistence on raising the fees to the employees on their accounts. And at the time, they would not budge. We were happy with their service, the direct keeping system, the education, and just the ongoing maintenance of the plan. But they just, we felt like that the fee was not in the best interest of the employees, so we came to you at that time while we were looking at other enhancements, which the board is to be commended for helping the employees try to get a better retirement. But part of that process is making sure that we're getting good service here at the staff level. And we just have not. I think y'all have been briefed by staff. We have, I think, gone bent over backwards in trying to work with One America. And again, the investments, I'm going to assure you that the investments are doing just fine. It's the service, and it's just too much is being put back on the county staff and us as your local folks providing the education. So it's our recommendation that we switch back to Mass Mutual. They have conceded the previous demand to increase the fee. So I guess, as I told Commissioner McCoy yesterday, absence makes the heart grow fonder. But in conjunction with that, we have now aligned with Retirement Funds of Georgia, which Mr. Bob Carter is here with us on, which oversees the Peace Officers Pension Fund for the state. So many of the county's employees are already in that fund. The magistrate judges, the probate judges, and the Superior Court clerks all have their fund under that umbrella. So we have a lot more buying power. So what Mass Mutual has committed to doing is, as other cities and counties join the fund, that the pricing would even get better for many of their counties. So we'll see how that goes. But the bottom line is today, the recommendation that we're putting forth is to go back to Mass Mutual.
Staff recommends that, right?
Absolutely. I know we have, you know, it has not been a good working relationship with the other.
A lot of promises were made that were not kept.
Yeah.
Let me, Madam Chair, if you don't mind, one quick question I think you clarifies this for me. Mass Mutual is a good, solid company. The only problem we had was the fees they were charging us. Now they have agreed to drop these fees.
Yes, sir.
So we're going back to them.
Yes, sir.
That's it in a nutshell?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Any questions? Any other questions?
Do we need to take action on that?
Yes, we'll take a motion to have a motion to go back with Mass Mutual.
So moved, Madam Chair.
All right, we have a second.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor? Thank you. Appreciate everyone's work on that. I know that'll be better for our state, certainly. All right, next is a quick claim D between Meriwether County Animal Shelter and Ricky J. Smith.
Chairman, Commissioners, this is a little quirky, so I'll take just a minute to explain what we're doing. We had a lady who passed away in her state in her will that named the animal shelter as a, you know, as an animal. So they were dollars they were going to put forth to the animal shelter. We have received those dollars. And in turn, now they're trying to sell a house. It's already transferred in the state, but they're trying to sell the house again. And in order to be sure everything is clear, and that we have no further claim against that house. They simply asked us to execute a quit claim deed, quit claiming any interest to that house. And so that's the purpose of this deed today, is just to clear up the titles and clear up the will and everything. And they had already designed this and sent this up for me to sign, so I actually signed and sent it back in. Just want to get it back in the records today for confirmation.
And I think I've asked you this, but just for public hearing, in no wise does our quit claim in any way reduce or have any impact on the endowment that she's leaving to them.
We've already got it.
We already got that.
That's all right.
This is just to clear the title. Susan could address that better than me, but it's just to clear the title going forward. They had everybody that was named as an heir execute a quit claim, and we were one of those.
Okay. All right, can we have a motion to confirm the administrator signing the quit claim deed?
So moved, Madam Chair.
We have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Thank you.
Thank you. All right, now we move along to Mr. Gregory and our finance report. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm just skipping right over. That's right. I wrote them up here. Okay, number six, joint IDA appointment. And we've got that in our... Ms. Chang, do you want to speak to that or anything about it?
Well, the Joint Development Authority is between Maryland County and the City of Paynesville, and the members are made up of our Development Authority board members and appointments from Hogan's. And so we just have, because we have new members on our board, we just need you to officially appoint them to the JDA board.
Okay.
We've got a meeting coming up soon. I just want to make sure they were official.
Okay, that would be the two newest members of the IDA is Rose LaPlante and Cheryl Moultrie.
Yes, so we need have one more to another appointment.
Okay, so we need a motion to also appoint them to the Joint Development Authority of Meriwether County and the City of Hogansville.
So moved.
All right, we have a second.
Second.
All in favor? Okay, all right, we got it. All right, next is the Student Protector Agreement, and we'll let Mr. Gay give us information on this.
Yes, Madam Chair and Commissioner. We have received, Judge Rasnick sent it to me, I think, through the sheriff. The sheriff had executed it as well. It's an agreement with between Gatekeeper Systems Incorporated and the Meriwether County School System. And what this is a camera video system they'll put on the buses. So when the arm comes out of the buses and people are supposed to stop, if they don't, they'll video and take a picture of the violator. And of course then what they're asking is that be prosecuted. And in lieu of the equipment they'll put on the bus, they get a portion of the fine. The only reason we're really involved in it is the courts and the fines that are collected come back to the county. But this is new revenue that we wouldn't have. Right now we're not doing this, so it's only a positive for the county. And on top of that, it's a positive for the school system and the safety of the children. The school system has already signed off on it, and sheriff's already signed off on it, and they're just waiting for us, and I think it's set up for my signature, so if I could get the board to just authorize me to sign this agreement. No other financial obligation from us. It'll be with the school system, and what I'll do is before I sign it, I'll get Susan to look at it one more time and just make sure we don't have any issues. But I've looked at it. Everything is fine.
Okay.
So,
hearing this information, can we have a motion to allow Mr. Gay to sign the Student Protector Agreement?
So moved.
Have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Thank you.
All right, and next will be number eight was the issuance of RFPs regarding our grass cutting.
Yes, ma'am. This will be for mowing and ground maintenance in three locations, Lake Meriwether, the Meriwether County Airport, and also the Industrial Park. We already have drafted a draft RFP for this. What I had to do is we run the aerial photograph as of yesterday, so we'll calculate the areas that have to be rough mowed and what has to be, like manicured. And we'll go ahead and put those together in documents. We don't meet again for like 20 days, so I don't really want to wait. I'd like to go ahead and get that out where we can get this awarded later than sometime in March.
Okay.
So that's the reason for asking. And the bids will come back to you guys for approval before we move forward.
Okay. Can we have a motion to allow the issuance of the RFPs for the grass cutting?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
I know we'll put these RFPs out, but is there a way that we can make sure all of our local people are aware of the RFPs? I mean, we can't make them apply, but whatever, there's a number of lawn services and...
Absolutely. We'll run the ad in the paper, and even see if Mr. Johnny would run just a short article for us in the paper as well. We'll post it, put it on our Facebook. And one of the reasons of bringing it up today is hopefully word will get out as well. And we'll be able to get, a lot of local interest in it. And, we'll send these out as three different RFPs. It'll give people the ability to, if you took on all three, that would be just about your job. But, that's right.
So when do we think we'll have these ready to go?
I think they'll be ready to go within 2 weeks.
Okay.
Out.
So that it'll be in the newspaper at
yes,
that time?
Yes, we'd like to advertise. I'm hoping to get these pretty well finished between now and this week, or maybe middle of next week, and have it ready to go. And then we'll try to advertise in next week's paper, and then the following week's paper. We are going to need to have a mandatory meeting on site, because while we're going to calculate the acreage of this and give them that, they still need to be able to look at it themselves and say, I was there. So we'll mention that, and I'll be talking about it, more as we go forward. But we'll try to get the word out. We'll search, Yellow Pages, any of them.
Well, I mean, I wonder, Ian, a business license.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
For lawn services or maintenance like that, I mean, that'd be a way that everybody might not have a license, they should, but might be a way to, I mean, I would just love to see this opportunity for somebody within our county, because they don't have to travel as far, it's going to have to be more beneficial to them, and I'm just like...
We've had a couple of firms approach Public Works about it.
Okay.
One firm approached Chief Pinesburg about it also.
Okay. Well, that's good.
And if we can identify those, we'll just go ahead and build in a...
I mean, you see vehicles around all the time. I haven't really paid attention to lots of the names, but I mean, you just see them in our area a lot.
The only thing that I see, the average lawn care or lawn maintenance people don't have the larger tractors or bush hogs.
Right.
That would be something they just have to...
But there's some of the others, I think, that do more... all these people that do like... deer plots and stuff in the off season. I mean, they have tractors and stuff, you would think, like I said, maybe they'll...
Yeah. So I hope we get a lot of... I kind of think we'll get a lot of interest in it. I hope that it is local.
That'd be good.
We'll push that as much as we can.
Okay.
And try to
identify
it.
All right, now we'll move on to Gregory and the finance.
We have a first this morning. I do not have the bank balances. The bank's website this morning,
it's down.
And they were doing some kind of upload or something. I don't know what it was.
Yeah.
Our general fund is still about $3.5 million. Contained in that is the $654 that we got from GDOT the other day for this current year's LMIG.
Mm-hmm.
So she gave probably speak on that a little bit later, so we're about ready to get started on that. Another thing is that Chief Pinesburg and Mr. Gay and myself met last week, I think it was, and set a little quote to a firm called Municipal Emergency Services to purchase 56 SCBA units for the fire department. So that's something that's been in the works for about 3 years, I think. It's long overdue, so we went ahead and got those along with the bottles that go with them. Price tag on it was a little bit more than what we originally budgeted in supplies, but that was 3 years ago, and we increased the quantity as well as the price went up. The total price tag is $329,000. But we have the funds and supplies set aside for that. So we'll have them, 3 months, you think?
Actually, they'll probably be delivered within 2 weeks.
Oh, great. Good.
This will bring us into compliance, too. We're not totally compliant.
On the EMA front, myself and the three deputy directors are going down to Taylor County next week for a meeting and to take a look at their new EOC facility so we can, you know, get some ideas to, on completing ours. And finally, we got a fax from Waste Management the other day, and I'll just read you. I hadn't had a chance to look into it real deeply yet, but it says, effective 2/1/17, Turkey Run Landfill will increase the county waste and county C&D waste tipping fees by 2.5%, subject to the terms in section 72 and 75. So that takes effect 2/1, so that's additional tipping fee. Not only is the volume of the gone up at the landfill, but the fees are going up now. So, and all the cities will go up as well. They'll be getting documentation from Waste Management on that. And we're looking at section 72 and 75 to figure out exactly what they say. But, and we'll bring this back to you guys at the next meeting to formally approve it. And that's all I have, unless you have any questions.
I do have one, Madam Chair. It's not directly related, but it's banking off what you just said. I had asked some time ago for the rules of the landfill to be brought and put on. Well, I see it on the website, so the average person can go out there and see the hours when you have free waste periods versus if you happen to go over there during the week and what you're going to have to pay. I would like to see that if we could get it on the website. People ask me about that.
Got a flyer and asking the city for information on where they ever sent that. I did have a flyer, but it really wasn't what I consider very informative. It just kind of told you a little bit. We'll do that.
Well, just suffice it to say that I know there's a minimum. If you take your pickup truck over there and we'll throw off a few things during the week,
right,
you're going to pay pretty well.
Yeah.
But we need that published out there.
Okay. We need to publish, especially for the Saturday, because that, like I said, that is all a part of our host agreement.
Absolutely.
That our citizens would have that advantage.
We'll do that. We'll put it on the website.
But that will be on
Facebook too.
Okay.
All right, is there anything else?
That's all.
Mr. Gay?
Okay, Madam Chairman. Give you guys an update. Let me start out with CSX. I talked to CSX last week, and they are completed with their portion of the bridges. So they've now said you can go ahead and get GDOT to inspect these. I've called GDOT and asked them to please inspect these bridges. Once the bridges are inspected and they meet their criteria, I know Tyrell and his group are working on the guardrails and the little joint between the pavement and that. So hopefully at your next meeting I'll be ready to bring back those agreements and finalization with CSX.
Are the guardrails up? Are they completed? No. Okay, are we close?
Well, we got to clean the roof first and then I'll start with the guardrails.
I'm just beginning to get calls.
Yeah.
About the bridge, and it's not really because the bridge isn't open, but it seems like the CSX is blocking the train crossing, and they did it for over 45 minutes the other day, and then shortly after that they did it again, and some people were late for school and that kind of thing. So I know we don't have really much control over CSX, but they're getting anxious for this to get open. And
I tell you, as soon as if we get those guardrails up and get the debris removed, as soon as GDOT says they're safe to open, we'll go ahead and open them anyway. And then that way, we'll bring the paperwork back up. But there's no reason to not open with that.
That's what we told when I called about it last week. Told us about hopefully within a couple of weeks.
Yes.
So, I mean, we're about a week past that now, so
right.
We can.
And I think, we'd be able to get the inspection done. I'm going to call them back again. I called them end of last week, but I haven't heard back. But I'll call them again today, and we'll work with Tyrell to get those things done, and then we'll be ready to open it back up. Even if we hadn't done the paperwork, there's no reason why we can't open it back up. Okay. So that was CSX. Would have mentioned that to you guys. Fire stations and the fire program's occupied a lot of our time. We've still working on locations and had an opportunity to talk to some of you guys about those. We're going to start reaching out to the owners as early as Friday. We met yesterday with the architect and engineers about the prototype stations. Once we identify these areas, we're going to go ahead ourselves and do the geotesting first, make sure everything perks. Then we will look at a survey. And before we close or buy anything, we'll get the engineers down to be sure there's not something that we didn't see that they do. And we're going to, you know, we're going to proceed with you know, making that happen. We looked yesterday at a design that, you know, was in Pike County. We looked at a Pike County fire station. We talked back with the architect yesterday about something very similar in size, but also with the capability to expand in the future if we needed to. So what we're trying to do is we got a lot to do. I mean, build eight or so stations and remodels is a lot of work. What we're going to try to do is to put these together in maybe a couple phases. On the ones that the property is relatively easy to acquire, we're going to get those coming out of the ground. While while that's happening, we'll move forward and getting the others, and we'll do that project alone. We're also going to need to finalize our spec on the fire trucks, because there's quite a lead time in getting the trucks sometimes. So we're probably in March. You guys are going to hear from us about, you know, maybe going ahead and issuing bids for the trucks where we can get that rolling. And financing, we did talk with Moody's in conference, and they, you know, very pleased with the positive outlook of the county. And we ended up with a Baa1, I think it is, rating, which is good. It's a good rating, and again, as we move forward in some of the things that are constructive, we'll even do better. We should have that funding available in mid to late March in terms of our bond, and that way we'll get to with you know, whatever we need to acquire and to build the turbine stations and trucks. So it's going to be a busy year. That's a major project unto itself. We've got a lot of other things going on, but you know, we're making good progress on it. Appreciate the chief and his staff, Keith and all they've done and all the work. So
I did see the building over in Pike County. I had seen it before, but I had to go to a meeting. I looked at it yesterday, but I noticed on the way over, and I couldn't go by it, somewhere between Molina and Williamson, on a side road, but close enough you could see off the main road, looked like another fire station maybe going up. Had red tin. Have y'all seen that? And because it had several bays on the front, it looked really nice. And then coming back yesterday, it was in all that storm, and I never could see where it was. I was coming back from the back side of it, but I wonder if you head that way, if you just look, it's on the left.
Okay.
And
Molina.
And Williamson, I turned in Williamson there to the left to go to Griffin. So, I mean, it was before there. I just don't remember exactly where. But like I said, if you're on the main road, you could see it facing a side road. And like it had several bays, and I just wondered maybe if it was another fire station.
They didn't mention.
And it may not. It may be somebody's shop or something. I don't know. But it looked nice. The tin was red.
Okay.
And it just caught my attention. It looked.
We looked at, we talked about...
Not bright red or dark, you know, red.
We talked about some styling cues. The one that I think you guys looked at, or one we looked at, which, you know, had the brick veneer around the outside. Mm-hmm. We even talked about some kind of stone veneer or something else. You could probably also, for very little cost, run maybe the edges with a stone and just give it a little more appeal. And we'll run through several of those scenarios and see what we can fund, and we'll try to get the very nice looking building. And we should have color options as well to be able to select from.
I do think that if we're putting it in residential or business, that it does need to fit in with the architecture.
Absolutely.
Wherever it is, because we don't want the citizens upset about having something just right there, in my personal opinion. So whatever area it's in, we need to try to match and make it look similar to
that. And you know, the some areas are known for, you know, this brick might work better in some areas, stone in some other areas. I think we talked about that the other day. And we're not talking about a lot of difference in cost. So before we get down to that final stage of that, we'll do that. But it's going to come pretty quickly.
That's where we're really pushing to get this thing together. Bill, anything else left to offer? Chief? You look. Okay. So, anyway, we're looking forward to that. We really appreciate it. LMIG, Bill mentioned that we got our dollars in. Here, very soon, we'll be putting together that program for bid as well. Not asking you guys for today, but we need to consider whether or not we want to use the same methodology of paving, or are there some roads that you would like to see us break out and do as conventional asphalt. So if y'all take a look at your roads, we were pretty aggressive with the roads that we put in, so there may be a couple that we need to, kind of come back with the budget. I don't want to spend too much of our SPLOST money over and above our match, because if we do, that's less money we have to match later. And I don't know for a fact, but sometimes if GDOT has additional dollars, I've seen them do a couple of different LMIGs in a year. So we have an opportunity in the fall, that would be wonderful as well. So we need to look at it going in. We also should be able to have some striping money coming this year. If it materializes, we will be able to list per conversations we've had, and so we'll take a look. We need to choose roads that are not going to be resurfaced in the next couple of years, but the striping is bad. I know you've got one that you get a lot of calls, so we'll put that one on the list. So those are some things that we are working with, but LMIG, I will start within the next couple of weeks calculating the roadways. I'm going to need to get the Tyrell and have it where we can ride and determine the patching areas. So we'll get that taken care of. Airport project. Somebody may have noticed out on the last front out here, we actually have the documents on display for the first phase of that project, which is obstruction clearance on the north south end of the airport. And anybody that's interested in bidding will need to contact Lead Edge. There's instructions out there. This is for a public display. Anybody can come and look at it, review the specs, whatever, but we can't give them that document. They'll have to purchase that back through Lead Edge. So those are on display out in the lobby.
Okay, on the south end of the airport, is that?
It's near the, it's sort of the end where the historic house is, but we're not doing anything.
Yeah, but is it trees and stuff that needs to be?
It is actually a raised area. If you're on the airport, there's a bank that comes up, and what they want you to do is they don't want to have anything within that zone that's higher than the center line of the landing strip. Mm-hmm. So we've got to cut that back. And then from there, the next phase of the project will be to go in the other direction. There's some rock outcroppings there that'll have to be cut back as well.
Okay, so but this specs is for the removal of that the raised area.
That's right.
Okay.
Just a berm area. On the I guess it's the south end of the airport.
It actually is the south end. Your heading's down there at 3618. That's about as north and south
as you have to get. Okay.
Good. Again, that's something that might be good to be on our website or Facebook page. Again, maybe somebody local could do.
Well, I had a couple local construction companies ask me to let them know, so I will actually call them
today.
Yeah,
they might need the builder.
Yeah, I'll call both of them today and let them know that it's available and ask them to come by and take a look at it. And this will be advertised, but there again, sometimes people don't always pick that up. But I'll make sure that the local contractors that we send out our other projects to are on that list. I'll be sure we put them out.
Does the county need builder anywhere?
For real?
Yes.
I was going to say, if they're going to remove it, maybe we can work something out where we get the dirt. I mean, I don't know. Like I said, we need it that way. We don't have to buy it.
We need it everywhere. The dirt we have over here now is real set and it's not won't pack real little round pipe and stuff. So we got a spot right at the airport when we stock it down there.
Okay.
We may need to get with Phil because he may have some plans for some of that dirt.
He might as well. They got a balance. There's some depressions down there. They'll simply move it into the depressions and level that.
Right.
Okay. And of course, it's a lot cheaper if you don't have to move it off site. Mm-hmm. But if they are going to have to move it, and we can use it,
Well, especially if we got a spot down there to store it.
Right.
And that would save us from having to obtain, a lot of times folks will give it if they're trying to clear something out, but I mean.
Yeah, they did give them a source in that area of the county as well. We would have to move it far and we could use it in that area. So we'll look into that.
We own land on both sides of that road.
We do. And they may have, I know they had some of it they're going to need, because I know there was right here they need to fill in, but I don't know that they're going to need all of that. So anyway, we're moving forward with that. I mentioned the fire truck specs already. I attended the recreation board meeting the other day. We met with a Boy Scout on the Eagle Project down at Lake Meriwether, and he's going to install 21 Bluebird boxes. And, you know, at first I thought, that's a lot. But when you get down there, you look at all the opportunities. I told him, I said, you know, you could put in 100 down here and still have plenty of space. So,
those are freestanding.
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 Oh, okay.
And we also talked to him. It was Carolyn's idea. I won't steal her idea. I'll give her credit for it. But she talked about having an interpretive sign or something there that would tell you a little bit about Bluebird.
Mm-hmm.
So he thought that was a good idea, and I think he's going to incorporate that as well.
Oh,
so that'll be good. And so we'll look at that. Our water and sewer local legislation has passed the House. It's gone over to the Senate. And so I would let you guys know about that. And that's all I have. Thank you.
All right, thank you. All right, now we have a report from the county commissioners.
I don't have anything against it.
I have just a couple of things I want to mention. Last night I had the opportunity to attend the Star Student, Star Teacher banquet in Manchester. And I just want to name off the students from Greenville Middle High School was Karen Azamar, from Flint River Academy, Maxwell Jark, and from Manchester High School, Rebecca Pierce. And I'm telling you, Mayor Prater was there as well. I was so impressed by the accomplishments of these students. Not only the star students, that means they have the highest score on the SAT. Each one of them is number one in their class. They're all going into engineering, varied types of engineering. One's going to University of Georgia, one's going to Georgia Tech, and one's going to Kennesaw State, which she'll probably have to go somewhere else to finish up, but our future is bright with these young people, and of course there's a lot to be said for their teachers and their parents as well, but I was just really impressed with them, and of course wish them all the very best, but I thought it was something that they're all going into engineering as well, and smart students from all three schools. Just a matter of information, I know I saw this online last week that our Senator Josh McCoon is not going to be seeking re-election, which I guess that will be in, he was just re-elected, I think, in the fall. So that, I don't know if there's people already throwing the hat in the ring, got a couple of years, but did see where he was not running again.
Not that much, but I would like to say that a couple of commissioners, me and Miss Mary, attended the Korean businessman's dinner hosted so well by Miss Jane back there. She whined and dined us, and I thought that was a nice event. Just one thing, the alerts we've been getting have been timely. The weather alerts is coming out, and I appreciate that. I don't even see Brent in here. I think that's, they're doing well, and we need those. Simply because you get an alert doesn't mean there's a tornado outside your door, but it still means you better be looking on the horizon to see what's going on.
Yesterday it was just for the thunderstorm
warning, yeah. That's exactly right.
If you're not
right.
Signed up for Code Red, you ought to,
sure
to
should.
Do that. Because I got it on
feature.
My cell phone and my home phone and
email. And the other thing I was going to say is thanks to Public Works, Bill Todd Road has been put back into service. We had a little blowout during the last rain event over there. So. But that's all I had, really.
All right, thank you. Susan? I don't have anything, Madam Chair. We will need a brief executive session for legal personnel and tax matters.
I knew you were going to say this.
It's a brief. Now we come time for public comment. If there's anyone in the audience that would like to say anything, if you would come to the podium and give us your name and address, and we'll give you 3 minutes to speak.
Just an absolute stampede coming up.
Colonel Routt, it's good to have you back.
It is good to see you back there.
Glad to be back, but you won't see me at night.
Oh, I'm so sorry, but glad you're here today. Our future meetings are February 20th is a holiday. February 28th will be our next meeting at 6 p.m. Can we have a motion to go in an executive session for the purpose of legal, real estate, and personnel?
So moved.
You have a second?
Second.
All in favor? Executive session.
Miss Beth, I need to get those roles names, all those people's names. Karen, just on the last name.
You can just have that if you want.
Perfect.
This is really rare.